Good morning everyone. Jnanaprabodhini is an institute which works under various fields such as education, research, health, women empowerment, rural development, etc. In the view of motivation building, attitude formation and man-making education. To bring about this idea in practice, Jnanaprabodhini has started Educational Activity Research Center. Under this, we have three main programs. First is Teachers Training Program, second is Educational Research Center, and third is Center for Nurturing Intelligence. Under Educational Resource Center, we are having this METS Club program. I am Neha Abhyankar and currently I am working as a coordinator of this particular program. As you all know, there are 25 lectures. One introductory lecture, that is today's lecture, plus 24 lectures. We have four subjects, that is mathematics, English, technology and science. For each subject, we will be having six lectures. So, in all, 24 lectures. For each subject, we will be having two to three videos related to topic, two to three activities and plus online lecture. This online lecture will be from 9 to 10 on every Saturday and on Zoom app. Same lecture is recorded and it is given on Google Classroom between 3 to 4 in the afternoon. Now, what is the difference between this METS Club and our regular online lectures which are having in your school? The difference, main difference I would say, that on online lectures, teacher is teaching, you are listening, you are writing down something, you are doing homework. Here, all these things you are not going to do at all. What you are going to do? Of course, you are going to do something, that is activities or experiments. But these activities or experiments will be totally new. On your own, at home, you have to do these activities. What we say, activity-based learning or learning by doing. Here, in these topics, we have multidisciplinary approach. That means, at the same time, you will be doing mathematics plus physics, something like that. There won't be any homework as such. If you have any doubt, you can call us, those who are in Pune, or you can mail us, if you get stuck up in between while doing the activities. And top of that, you have to do evaluation. Two types of evaluation will be done. First is self-evaluation and second is parents' evaluation. You have to judge yourself. At the same time, parents will be also evaluating you people. Now, this evaluation is not at all difficult. We will be providing you a checklist. And through that checklist, you have to evaluate yourself. Now, let me introduce our faculty members, Swapnita Date. She has completed her PhD in molecular biophysics. Currently, she is working as senior scientist in Vanderbilt University, USA. She is a science design consultant and at the same time, STEM outreach program consultant. She is also working as a STEM program coach.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. I am so very happy to meet you all and I'm very excited to work with you through this program. We are sitting at least 13,500 kilometers away. While you have just started your day, I'm still in yesterday. Isn't it exciting? Despite the distance and time difference, we feel like we are right in front of each other. And that's technology. This is exactly what we are going to celebrate through this program, Understand Science and Technology. I will primarily talk to you about science aspects of this program and I'm going to give you three rules. If you follow these rules, I promise you're going to be very successful. My name is Swapnita Date and I am a senior scientist here in Tennessee in the United States. I'm a molecular biologist. I study proteins. We have thousands of these proteins inside each of our cells and I'm certainly going to talk to you about biology in the coming 25 weeks. We are going to learn not only about few topics in biology, but also chemistry, physics, and interdisciplinary sciences. You will learn about plants, microorganisms. You will learn about light, and you will learn about chemistry happening right in your kitchen. And this is not going to be some boring lecture that you have to sit through. You will actually see and do some experiment right at your home. How cool is that? Let me tell you a little secret. I wasn't the smartest student in my class. In fact, for one of the science assignments, I scored 6 out of 10 marks. Everyone else in class got like 8, 9 or 10 out of 10 marks. If someone would have told me back then that I was going to be a scientist, I would have never believed them. Back then, everyone used to ask me, are you going to be a doctor or an engineer? I'm glad I found a way to be a scientist. As a doctor, I could have helped maybe one patient at a time. As a scientist, I can do things that can help millions of people. And that's my rule number one for you guys. Never limit yourself. Never say, I only got 6 marks in science. I don't think I should do science. Or I can't become a dancer because my mom says, don't go to science. Go to science and not arts. Don't say I have poor English or poor math. You can always find people to help you and guide you. And you're already doing well by participating in this program. In this program, you're going to have some lessons and also some fun activities to do. For example, Ravi Dada is going to teach you about light and topics and optics. And then he will teach you about experiments you can do using things available at your home. Our Neeraja Thai, she's going to teach you and show you chemistry experiments that you can do in your kitchen. Pay a lot of attention, learn as much as you can, and do all the activities we ask you to do. And then my rule number 2, go an extra mile. What this means is always do something extra and something better. If I ask you to make a list of 5 microorganisms, find 2 extra. And this is the success mantra to have a successful career. If you do extra work at home, your mom is going to be super happy. Maybe she will buy you new clothes or cook something you really like. If you always go extra mile when you have a job, you will get bonus, awards, and soon you will start enjoying everything. And then my rule number 3, always ask questions. There is so much that we don't know in this world. Do you know that 80% of our ocean is unexplored? We don't know how it looks, who lives there. We human beings, we have been on this earth for millions of years. We still don't know the function of 20% of our proteins inside our body. Don't even ask me about the universe. There is only 4 to 5% of the universe that we know. More than 95% is unexplored. What you learn in school is about the things that we already know. But you should be focusing on things or answers to the question for which we don't have answer. So my rule number 3, always ask questions. You have wonderful instructor here. Reach out to them with your question. Ask your parents. You have most powerful resource with you, the internet. Look up answers to your question. You can also email scientists. I promise they would never call you silly. Make it a rule to ask or come up with at least 2 questions anytime you learn something new or attend a lecture. I do a lot of science activities with young children here in the US. And many times students ask us, soon we are going to have robots to do things for us. Robots are going to replace humans. What are we going to do when robots are doing our job? And I always tell them 3 rules. 1, never limit yourself. 2, always go an extra mile. And 3, wonder, explore, ask a lot of questions. These are the things robots cannot do. Robots are designed to do exactly what we want them to do. And all the successful and intelligent work will still be done by human beings. Humans like you. So good luck. Enjoy every opportunity and make the most of this program. Also, invite your friends to join this program. Make it more fun. I will see you soon in some of the lectures. Bye-bye.
Neeraja Dashaputre. She completed her PhD in chemistry from University of Maryland College of Park. Being passionate about science education and outreach, she is currently working as a senior technical officer at ICER Pune.
Hello everyone, how are you doing? My name is Neeraja and I will be talking a little bit about the activities in the technology part of the JPP Meds Club. But before we go ahead with activities, I want to ask you a question. Can you really figure out why we use technology and for what kind of problems, or to answer what kind of problems do we really need technology? You know, all of us are really using a lot of technology these days. We have apps, we have various programs, websites that we use, you know, and technology is all around us. But do you know that in order to answer really challenging questions, we must use technology? So let me ask you a question. When the initial coronavirus pandemic was declared in India and we had a lockdown of 21 days, did you wonder why 21 days? How did they come up with that number? It's a really difficult problem to solve. How do I come up with how many exact number of days we probably need to contain the virus? And to answer such questions, we really need the help of computers. We really need to, you know, feed enough data to the computer, let it analyze it. But remember, the computer is not analyzing the data on its own. We first need to train the computers how to analyze that data, right? So how do we write a code that helps us to solve a particular problem? And really, coronavirus is just an example. We are currently facing a lot of problems, a lot of difficult and really, you know, huge problems that we are facing as humankind together. Take for example, global warming. How do we really understand the impact of various activities, activities that humans are performing or the natural activities on the temperature of the whole earth? It's really huge data. So in such cases, we have to use computers. We have to take their help in order to analyze the data. But again, we have to first train the computer on how to analyze the data. So that is where the whole computational thinking comes in place. We need to first learn how a computer thinks. We need to learn its language. And so various activities in the technology part really begin from introduction to programming. We are going to learn how to code from experts. We are going to probably write a small code in the beginning, but you know, take it forward if you really like that activity. We also have activities wherein you might be able to build your own virtual reality box, you know, and if you have a smartphone with you, you really can enjoy, amazing landscapes, maybe underwater experience just sitting at home. So we are going to do some really exciting things under virtual reality too. Another activity that is being planned, and you are really going to decide how this really ends up, is to make an app. So all of you are using various apps these days, and I'm sure that your life is right now full of different kinds of apps, some that you like, some that you probably don't like. But have you ever wondered what goes behind or the back end of the app? How is it supported? And that's going to be really an interesting project, because you're going to decide what app you want to make. You're going to take it forward. So really, how much we proceed in the technology club it all depends on how much enthusiasm you show. Because we have experts from various fields. We have experts who do programming for a living. We have experts who make apps. We have experts who code. We have experts who make virtual reality simulators, as a part of their job, and all of them will be here to guide you. So personally, I'm not an expert. I am not a technologist, but I'm going to be learning with you, and I'm super excited to learn these new things. Are you excited to learn? Are you excited to learn with me? So we really hope that you enjoy the technology portion of the Meds Club. Let's start learning.
Next faculty member is English faculty member, that is Supriya Thai Darpa. She was formerly teaching in Jnana Prabodhini Prashala. Now currently she is working as a director of studies in Dynaspeak English School in Auckland, that is in New Zealand. Namaskar. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the JP Mates online program organized by Jnan Prabodhini. Let me first introduce myself. My name is Supriya Darp. You know, the best part of the online teaching and learning is that you can be anywhere in the world, but still can see each other and interact with each other. At this moment, I'm talking to you from the last right-hand corner of the world, close to Antarctica. Can you guess where? Yes, I'm in New Zealand, in Auckland. The whole world is passing through extremely difficult times. The global pandemic has completely affected our daily lives since last 6 months. 6 months is a long period when you cannot go out and have a free life. You are always worried about your health. You can't go to school, you can't be with your class friends and your teachers, and you can't be in your classrooms sitting on your bench with your friend. You can't play with your friends on the school playground. And I'm very sure you must be missing all these things, which are an integral part of your life. However, you can't stop your studies. You can't waste your time doing nothing at home. Your school must be giving you some online lessons on Zoom or other platforms. Your teachers must have given you a lot of work to complete, but it is not similar to be in an actual class. There's a lot of uncertainty around this. We must deal with this situation positively on our front. That is the reason why we have made a learning plan for you. The JP Mates is planning to engage you with four major areas of your studies: mathematics, English, technology, and science. You've already been told about this by the previous people. I will talk a little about the learning plan for English. Now, we have got total 6 sessions for you. You have got 6 very interesting themes for you, and we will be working around those themes. We will give an assignment to work on for the whole week. This assignment will include 1 task each for reading a text and answering the questions, listening to a dialogue or a monologue and answering questions, a task on vocabulary where we will include lot of creative activities for you, and also grammar. Writing will be quite interesting. We will try to cover some micro skills in writing, such as spelling, punctuation, paragraphing, linking ideas with right linking words, writing a topic sentence and supporting details, etc. But we will also give you an activity to work on for a week and try and write the reports based on these activities. These activities are going to be really, really interesting, believe me. The main objective is to increase your overall proficiency in English, give you more confidence to use English in your daily lives. Though we have maintained the level of your classes and followed the school syllabus objectives, we have not exactly followed your textbook as it is. Your reading, listening, grammar, and vocabulary tasks will be marked automatically, but you will have to submit your activities before the next Saturday session. You will have 1 week to work on the activity given to you. So make sure that you submit your work very much on time. We will mark your work and give you feedback, which will be useful for you. Time management, remember, is extremely important. On a Saturday, when you meet your teacher during the online session, your teacher will explain you what kind of assignments you will be doing during the week and teach you important things necessary for you to complete the assignments. He or she, your teacher, will explain you the activity and what you are expected to do. The assignment will be posted to you on Google Classroom immediately after the class. If you plan your work properly, it will be approximately 3 hours work, but you need to concentrate and plan properly. If you have any difficulties while working,
You can send a message to your teacher and he or she will try to answer you as quickly as possible. You will receive the feedback on your activities before the next session. This is just the primary introduction. We will try our best to support you with your English studies as we progress. Let us work together and make the most of it. Yes, all the best for your program. Thank you.
Kiran Barve sir, he'll be teaching mathematics. In Pune, there is a Bhaskaracharya Pratishthan. He is the faculty member of Bhaskaracharya Pratishthan. This particular institute, it leads to International Mathematics Olympiad. Kiran Barve sir was the deputy leader of Indian team in 2014, which was held in Cape Town, that is in South Africa.
Hello and welcome parents and students. My dear students, you are going to enroll in MATES program, and mathematics is an integral part and important session of this course. Myself Kiran Barve, Siddhartha Bhalerao sir and Nachiket Panse will be conducting this course. Siddhartha Bhalerao sir is a postgraduate teacher in mathematics. Nachiket Panse is also very good in mathematics. He is an engineer and very good teacher. The basis of these sessions is activity-based learning. When you read something, you slightly understand. When you try to write, you may remember. But when you do it by yourself, you thoroughly understand and you know the subject. So activities and teaching will be going on together. There are main 4 or 5 themes of mathematics in general. That is numbers, shapes, assigning numbers to the shapes, and symmetry. Symmetry is one of the important aspects in mathematics and it is inherent in every walk of life. Also in the high school syllabus, arithmetic is also an essential topic. The topics and contents are devised keeping in mind these themes. The topics for 5th and 6th are numbers, fractions, shapes, symmetry, a lecture on interplay of mathematics with the other subjects, and a special lecture. For 7th and 8th, it is ratio, proportion, variation. 2nd is the variables and abstractions begins. And then there is congruency, Pythagoras theorem, mensuration. Again, the lecture depicting interplay and special lecture. Now, before any session, we will send you some links or video or slideshow. When you view this and understand this, you will be prepared for the session and your revision will be complete. Actually, in the session, there will be 15-20 minutes of the teaching, and then there will be a simple activity. Teacher will demonstrate the activity, and along with the teacher, students have to do it. The activities will be very simple, easy to understand, and related to the topic discussed. The material that is used in these activities and the other activities we will give as homework will be very simple, like a thread, a paper, a stone, and even some utensils and objects in kitchen. After those activities, again in the session, the activity again, it will be followed by the teaching, and the session will end with activity or experiment. Experiment in mathematics is something unheard of. But yes, you can do many experiments in mathematics. You can enjoy them. You will have different observations and you learn by yourself. So that is a very enchanting part of our course. Under post session scenario, we will be giving assignments. The first level of the assignment is of worksheets and sums, which will strengthen the procedural abilities. Second is a bit difficult problems. Problems require thinking and some longish activities which may take 1 hour or so to do. In the third level, creativity will be challenged. The students will have to do some open-ended experiments or solve some open-ended like problems in which they will have to use their ingenuity and thereby their love for mathematics and understanding of mathematics will be boosted. How we are going to evaluate the students? Well, who are we to evaluate the students? The student should evaluate themselves. So there is a self-evaluation process. And the parents will also let us know whether they are participating with interest or if there are any difficulties in participation. Friends, students, mathematics is a game. It has its own objects in numbers, shapes, angles, right angle, in whatever ways. You know all that. There are well-defined rules. So it is just like cricket or badminton with its bat and ball and stumps, racket and shuttle and the rules. So let us play game of mathematics together. Let us enjoy mathematics and grow with it. Thank you.
Next faculty member is Dr. Nalini Gujarati. Formerly, she was working as a principal of Jnanaprabodhini Prashala. She completed her PhD in scientific creativity. Currently, she is working as a member of Academic Advisor Committee for Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan.
Dear children and parents, Namaskar. Myself, Dr. Nalini Gujarati, want to conclude this introductory session of MEDS Club activities. All our experts have well explained the objectives behind these activities in their respected subjects. I am sure that children will learn maximum by doing these activities because the 3 H, head, heart, and hands are involved in them. Please note that we don't want to teach the text content through mugging type of activities, but we expect that children should understand the scientific concepts, develop scientific attitude, learn applications of the concept in day-to-day life, grasp the thinking skills like logical thinking, reasoning, and enhance creativity while doing these unique activities. All these activities are interactive so that children can communicate their reactions, they can ask difficulties and share new ideas. They are going to self-evaluate their activities. The competition is with the self. So everybody will be the winner and everybody will be the achiever. I do remember the stories of scientists which throw light on their childhood. Thomas Alva Edison, who discovered electric bulb after thousands of persistent efforts, was fond of preparing novel machines. In his childhood, he prepared one electric machine to kill cockroaches. Famous scientist Albert Einstein failed in physics at college. But these things don't matter in life. What matters is your interest, your passion, your motivation, and your involvement in the work. Here, I would like to tell more about developing scientific creativity while doing these activities. Most important creativity skills are observation, curiosity, and inquisitiveness. Keenly observe what is happening in the activity. Make minute observations, make abnormal observations, which lead to curiosity and problem finding. Why and how a particular thing is happening? This will create curiosity and inquisitiveness. Many questions will raise in your mind. Try to find out innovative ideas or solutions for these questions. I will quote some interesting examples. In the national competition for innovative ideas organized by IGNITE in the memory of past president late Shri Abdul Kalam, ideas suggested by rural illiterate students obtained prizes. They suggested, say, a torch in a spectacle to read at night, an additional pedal for travelers in a manual rickshaw to decrease physical exertion of the driver, brushes and brooms attached to a cycle to clean the road, and so on. We welcome novel ideas from you too. There are important 6 creative abilities in science and technology which can be developed through these activities. 1. Finding the difficulties and sensing the problems, as in the above examples. Say, for example, what are the difficulties in the operation of a gas cylinder? 2. Asking questions. You can ask questions on the life cycle of honeybees. 3. Finding root causes. Why we should use a mask in a corona pandemic? You can find out the cause behind that. Guessing consequences. What will be the consequences of online education in the various fields of life? 5. Finding out new uses. Say, for example, new uses of drone. You have seen some uses of drone in the picture. 6. Is making improvements in the existing apparatus or any machine. Say, for example, improvement in a fan, in AC, in a software, in a mobile app, or say in a robo, and so on. You will learn about these in due course of time. We have separate activities to develop writing skills in English, which will be very useful to you in day-to-day life. At the end, I will say that enjoy learning from these activities. If you like these activities of Maths Club, inform your friends in school, in the society, so that more children will be benefited. Thank you.
So all these are our faculty members. I'm sure that you will enjoy all the things. I also feel that while doing experiments or activities, if you get any wow factor, please let us know. We are waiting to appreciate all these things. Now, to conclude this, I would like to thank all of you, those who have joined this particular program, and please make 100% benefit of this particular program. Do all the activities. If you have any problem, anytime you can mail us, anytime those who are in Pune, they can call us. We'll definitely give you a hint or clue and you can proceed further. So all the best for your lectures, activities and demonstration, and from ERC Met Club members. Thank you.